Charlie the Bird Parker. Since then, Shearing became one of the country's most popular performing artists. In 82 and in 83, he won Grammy Awards for recordings he made with Mel Torme. He's played for three presidents at the White House, Mr. Ford, Mr. Carter, and Mr. Reagan. He is the winner of many, many honorary doctorates and many honors. He received the Horatio Alger Award for Distinguished Americans in 1978. And in 2007, he was knighted by Queen Elizabeth II, Sir George Shearing. While Shearing is best known as a jazz pianist, he also succeeded as a composer. And tonight's work was written both for piano and later by Shearing himself for the organ. So we hear Shearing's version of Come Ye Sinners Poor and Needy, the M-Tune Consolation.
Thank you.
of San Francisco, Paul Desmond was one of the leading proponents of West Coast cool jazz. Influenced by Lester Young and Pete Brown, he originally played clarinet in several big bands, but it was his partnership with the formerly trained pianist David Brubeck that sent him to fame on the concert stage. Desmond's melodic solos were in marked contrast to the rhythms of Brubeck, but somehow it clicked and they drove each other to greatness. After meeting and playing together in the late 40s, they formed the Dave Brubeck Quintet in 1951, and they never looked back. For the critics, it was a very strange musical relationship. Some people found that Brubeck's playing was very heavy-handed, and Desmond, meanwhile, was considered to be playing too sweetly, but together it seemed to work. When the Brubeck Quartet broke up in 1967, Desmond unofficially retired. He was 43 years old, and he didn't play his horn again for 3 years. At first glance, we look at his career and say it was perhaps insignificant. But then we hear people such as Charlie Parker, who named him his favorite alto player, Cannonball Adderley, who was an arch rival, said, "I believe that Paul Desmond shares with Benny Carter the title of the most lyrical altoist and a profoundly beautiful player." Tonight's selection, Take Five, remains as the most popular work from the Desmond and Brubeck duo. Here's a little about what Dave Brubeck said about the piece, not what Paul Desmond, so you have to keep that in mind. He said, "Take Five goes back to an idea that I had in the early 40s. I used 5/4 in 1946 in a two piano piece, and I wanted to do a whole album of things that were not in the typical 4/4 meter of jazz. So I went to Paul Desmond and his drummer Joe Morello, and I said, let's write this thing. You're warming up every night and you're doing things like this, let's put it down on paper. So Joe's playing in 5 and you're trying to play against him in 4. I'll write the rest of the material, but you guys already have a start, 5/4. So according to Dave Brubeck, this piece was born that way. Take 5 was born in his front room. It has two themes. Paul said it had two themes, but he wasn't able to write the tune. So Brubeck said, if you'll put the two themes together, and we're going to have a new piece, and it's going to be a hit. So they sat down and they made it happen. We hope you enjoy. I think it'll be familiar to most of you. Take 5 by Paul Desmond. Cy Coleman was a classically trained child prodigy, a concert pianist who turned into a popular songwriter and a Broadway tunesmith. He made his Carnegie Hall debut as a soloist at age 7, and by his late teens, he had become somewhat of a society darling, performing jazz piano in sophisticated New York nightclubs. By the 1950s, he had turned to composing pop standards for the likes of Frank Sinatra and Nat King Cole, and he ran his own New York nightclub called The Prelude. In 1966, Coleman took his rhythmic, upbeat, jazzy scores and added the words of a veteran lyricist, Dorothy Fields, and came up with a score for the Broadway show, Sweet Charity. He won 3 Tony Awards for his brilliant jazz-inflected score in the witty and stylish film noir musical, The City of Angels, and for a score called Will Rogers Follies, which is fairly recent. Coleman composed his first film score for Father Goose, 1964, and that included a song, Pass Me By, and composed scores for several other films. Tonight, we're going to hear the hit song from his show, Sweet Charity, Hey, Big Spender, by Cy Coleman.